Gigue, the last movement of the first Bach Cello Suite. Again, I don't transpose these. I know for some purists that's insulting, but I prefer to be able to play my low C when it's called for. It's nice to be able to use the full range of the instrument. So the cello's low C and my low C, we both get to use it. So that disclaimer aside, let's talk a little bit about how to approach this. Gigue is a dance, a jig, okay? And you definitely want to play something that has a lilt to it so that, you know, you could feasibly dance to it if you were wearing powdered hair. So the way you do that is with your air. Instead of playing something, I really emphasize each of the beats. So you really feel the 6/8. So you want to do that through this entire piece. The whole piece needs to have that the dance feeling to it, or it just stays kind of flat. Second thing here is I want to talk about articulation. If I would like you to pay attention to the fact that I use many different kinds of tonguing to achieve the feel of this piece. Da, 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 da. Ta. So there's less air behind those tongues. Now here, it's very light tonguing. Da, 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 da. So we have the and. So all of these are different kinds of articulations. So you really need to practice different ways of tonguing to make sure you can bring all of this out, because it gives the whole piece a lot of nuance that I think is really appropriate. So I encourage all of you to play Bach all the time. It is definitely in the foundation of my, if it were a food group, practice group, it would be on the bass where there were a lot of grains. So a lot of Bach is good for you. Okay, see you next time. Thanks.